Good morning to you all. Today I wish to discuss 50 important multiple choice question related to Central Civil Service Conduct Rule 1964, focusing on the action permitted and prohibited for central government employees in India. Question number 1, which rule under CCS Conduct Rule 1964 deal with the general conduct for government servant? Option A, Rule 5, Option B, Rule 3, Option C, Rule 12, Option D, Rule 8. The correct answer is Rule 3. Option B is the correct answer. Question number 2, central government employees are prohibited from engaging in which of the following activities? Option A, borrowing from the cooperative societies. Option B, participating in demonstration. Option C, holding shares in public companies. Option D, giving public speeches. Correct answer is B, participation in demonstration. Question number 3. As per Rule 4 of the CCS Conduct Rule 1964, a government employee is permitted to. Option A, give public speech criticizing government policy. B, engage in political activity. C, maintain a proper decorum in private life. D, participate in a strike. The correct answer is C, maintain a proper decorum in private life. Question number 4, under CCS Conduct Rule 1964, central government employees are prohibited from Option A, taking part in election in cooperative societies. Option B, using official position to secure private gain. Option C, attending social functions. Option D, making investment in mutual fund. The correct answer is B, using official position to secure private gains. Question number 5, as per Rule 13 of CCS Conduct Rule, a government servant is permitted to Option A, accept gift from relatives for personal events. Option B, accept gift from commercial firm with which he or she has official dealing. Option C, accept any gift of more than rupees 5000 without reporting it. Option D, accept foreign awards without government approval. The answer is option A, to accept gift from relatives for personal event. Question number 6, the participation in a political rally by a central government employee is option A, permitted, option B, not permitted, option C, permitted with prior approval, option D, conditional. The correct answer is not permitted, that is option B is correct answer. Question number 7, as per conduct rule, central government employees are prohibited from option A, marrying more than one spouse while the first marriage subsists. Option B, publishing book without prior approval. Option C, attending public meetings. Option D, receiving fee for public work. The correct answer is A, marrying more than one spouse while the first marriage subsists. Question number 8, which rule governs the acceptance of dowry by the government employees? Option A, Rule 18, Option B, Rule 13A, Option C, Rule 17, Option D, Rule 9. The correct answer is Option B, that is Rule 13A. Question number 9, according to Rule 15, central government employees are allowed to Option A, engage in private trade or employment. Option B, accept part-time employment with prior permission. Option C, engage in speculative investment. Option D, join or assist in a political party. The correct answer is B, accept part-time employment with prior permission. Question number 9. According to Rule 15, central government employees are allowed to Option A, engage in private trade or employment. Option B, accept part-time employment with prior permission. Option C, engage in speculative investment. Option D, join or assist a political party. The correct answer is B, accept part-time employment with prior permission. Question number 10. Under the CCS, conduct rule 1964, a central government employee can be a member of option A, a registered trade union, option B, a political party, option C, a religious organization, option D, a gambling syndicate. The correct answer is option A, a registered trade union. So only a central government employee can be a member of a registered trade union. Rest are banned. Question number 11. Rule 18 of CCS conduct rule requires a central government employee to option A, declare gift received from friends on social occasions, option B, declare their asset and liabilities every 1 year, option C, engage in any employment after retirement, option D, invest in share of private companies. So correct answer is option B, declare their asset and liabilities every 1 year. That is under rule 18. Question number 12. Are central government employees are allowed to criticize the government in a public forum? Option A, yes, if they do so in a personal capacity. Option B, no, under no circumstances. Option C, yes, with prior permission. Option D, yes, if it is related to a policy they disagree with. The correct answer is B, no. Under no circumstances, a central government is allowed to criticize the government in a public forum. Question number 13. According to CCS conduct rule, are central government employees allowed to gamble? Option A, yes. Option B, no. Option C, yes, if it is not habitual. Option D, yes, if done privately. The correct answer is no. No central government employee is allowed to gamble. Question number 14. Rule 16 deal with the central government employee's participation in option A, election, option B, cultural activities, option C, investment decisions, option D, demonstration and strike. The correct answer is C, investment decisions. Question number 15. Central government employees are prohibited from option A, accepting wedding gift from close relatives, option B, joining a religious organization, option C, accepting a dowry, option D, attending political rallies in a personal capacity. Correct answer is option C, accepting a dowry. Question number 16. Rule 3.2 of CCS conduct rule directs that every central government employee shall option A, maintain absolute integrity, option B, write articles in newspaper, option C, maintain social media profiles, option D, participate in political campaigns. So correct answer is A, maintain absolute integrity. Question number 17. Can central government employee participate in strike under CCS conduct rule 1964? Options are A, yes, B, no, C, yes, with prior permission, D, yes, under exceptional circumstances. The correct answer is B, no. Question number 18. Rule 13 prohibits government employees from option A, attending a colleague wedding, option B, taking dowry or giving dowry, option C, borrowing from a financial institution, option D, traveling without information to the department. Correct answer is B, taking dowry or giving dowry. Question number 19. Under CCS conduct rule, a government servant may option A, raise public funds for private use, option B, offer public criticism of a government policy, option C, keep public funds in personal custody, option D, make suggestion for improving government policies. Correct answer is D, make suggestion for improving government policies. Question number 20. Employees are required to report the acquisition of movable or immovable property under which rule? Option A, rule 16, option B, rule 18, option C, rule 9, option D, rule 5. The correct answer is rule 18, that is option B. Question number 21. Can a central government employee accept foreign awards without prior government approval? Option A, yes. Option B, no. Option C, yes, if it is non-monetary. Option D, yes, under special circumstances. The correct answer is B, no. Question number 22. Is a government servant allowed to give or take loans from a person having official dealing? Option A, yes. Option B, no. Option C, yes, with approval. Option D, yes, if it is for charitable purpose. The correct answer is B, no. No government servant is allowed to take or to give loans from a person having official dealing. Question number 23. What is the limit for a central government employee accepting wedding gift without reporting it? Option A, rupees 1000. Option B, rupees 5000. Option C, rupees 25000. Option D, rupees 50000. The correct answer is option B, rupees 5000. Question number 24. According to CCS conduct rule, government servant can option A, engage in business. Option B, accept hospitality from foreign diplomats. Option C, organize private social function. Option D, criticize government decision on social media. The correct answer is C, organize private social functions. Question number 25. The CCS conduct rule 1964 require employee to option A, submit annual property return. Option B, participate in political rallies. Option C, discuss classified information. Option D, donate to political parties. The correct answer is A, submit annual property returns. Question number 26. Central government employee can join option A, registered charitable organization. Option B, foreign companies without prior approval. Option C, political parties. Option D, religious conversation. The correct answer is option A, registered charitable organization. Question number 27. Engaging in speculative investment by government employee is option A, encouraged. Option B, prohibited. Option C, permitted with prior approval. Option D, none of the above. The correct answer is B, prohibited. Question number 28. Can central government employees participate in processions or demonstration related to political cause? Option A, yes, always. Option B, yes, with prior approval. Option C, no, never. Option D, yes, if not in uniform. Correct answer is C, no, never. Question number 29. Government servant may receive complimentary tickets from a business. Option A, anytime. Option B, never. Option C, if approved by their department. Option D, during holidays. The correct answer is B, never. A government servant never may receive the complimentary ticket from a business partner. Question number 30. If a government servant is allowed to participate in a cultural program during official hours, option A, yes. Option B, no. Option C, yes, with prior approval. Option D, none of the above. So correct answer is C, yes, he may attend, but with prior approval. Question number 31. A central government employee is allowed to receive gift from personal friend when? Option A, the value is less than 1000. Option B, the value is less than 2500. Option C, the value is less than 5000 without reporting it. Option D, the value is over 5000 with permission. The correct answer is C, the value is less than 5000 without reporting it. Question number 32. According to CCS conduct rule, a government servant must not option A, attend religious ceremonies in private. Option B, own shares in a public company. Or C, accept gift from a business organization he deals with officially. Option D, participate in sporting events. The correct answer is C, accept gift from a business organization he deals with officially. Question number 33. A government servant must declare immovable property acquired or disposed of exceeding option A 20,000, option B 25,000, option C 50,000, option D 1 lakh. The correct answer is option D 1 lakh. Question number 34. According to CCS Conduct Rule 1964, a government employee, option A, can be a part of a private trade or business. Option B is prohibited from using his position for personal benefit. Option C is allowed to lobby for policies privately. Option D can accept loans from colleagues. So correct answer is B, is prohibited from using his position for personal benefit. Question number 35. Can a central government employee publish a book without prior sanction? Option A, yes, if it does not criticize the government. Option B, no, always require approval. Option C, yes, if it is a fictional work. Option D, yes, under condition if it does not relate to official work. The correct answer is no, always require approval. Question number 36. As per CCS Conduct Rule 1964, a government employee, option A, can appear on public platform to criticize government policies. Option B, must avoid indulging in act which bring disrepute to the government. Option C, can participate in a strike of a registered trade union. Option D, are allowed to organize mass protest. Correct answer is B, must avoid indulging in act which brings disrepute to the government. Next, question number 37. Rule 22 of the CCS Conduct Rule state that central government employee must refrain from, option A, marrying a foreign national. Option B, criticizing the government on social media. Option C, consuming alcohol during duty hours. Option D, participating in political debates. The correct answer is option C, consuming alcohol during duty hours. Question number 38. The government servant must report any borrowing firm. Option A, bank. Option B, cooperative societies. Option C, persons or firm with whom they are having official dealing, or option D, relatives. The correct answer is C, persons or firm with whom they have official dealing. Question number 39. Government employees can accept awards from foreign government. Option A, freely. Option B, with prior approval of the government. Option C, only after retirement. Option D, with permission from the head of their department. The correct answer is B, or with the prior approval of the government. Question number 40. Is central government employee allowed to be involved in management of a private company? Option A, yes. Option B, no, under no circumstances. Option C, yes, with prior permission. Option D, yes, with retirement. After retirement. The correct answer is C, yes, with prior permission. Question number 41. According to CCS Conduct Rule 13, acceptance of gift by the government servant, option A, is permitted during ceremonial occasion with restriction. Option B, is completely prohibited. Option C, is allowed only if reporting within 7 days. Option D, is permitted only from foreign officials. Correct answer is A, is permitted during ceremonial occasions with restrictions. Question number 42. A government servant can engage in private consultancy work. Option A, freely. Option B, only after retirement. Option C, with prior approval from department. Option D, only if it does not involve financial gain. The correct answer is with prior approval from the department. Question number 43. Can a central government employee use official resources for personal reason? Option A, yes, within limits. Option B, no, it is strictly prohibited. Option C, yes, with permission. Option D, yes, if reimbursed. Correct answer is B, no, it is strictly prohibited. Question number 44. A central government employee is allowed to take part in, option A, political debates during election. Option B, cultural activities organized by government. Option C, meeting of political parties. Option D, demonstration on public issues. The correct answer is B, cultural activities organized by government. Question number 45. According to CCS Conduct Rule 1964, a government employee must, option A, accept financial aid from foreign organization, option B, avoid habitual indebtedness, option C, avoid financial saving and investment, option D, borrow from official vendors regularly. The correct answer is option B, avoid habitual indebtedness. Question number 46. Can a central government employee take a second spouse during the lifetime of first spouse? Option A, yes, if the first spouse consents. Option B, yes, under special personal circumstances. Option C, no, unless permitted by government. Option D, no, strictly prohibited. The correct answer is C, no, unless permitted by government. Question number 47. Government servant must seek permission before leaving the country. Option A, for personal reason. Option B, only if it is official work. Option C, for both official and personal reason. Option D, if the trip is financed by someone else. The correct answer is C, for both official and personal reason. Question number 48. Under Rule 18 of CCS Conduct Rule, government servant are required to declare option A, their political affiliation, option B, their immovable property details every year, option C, their immovable and movable property at the interval, option D, all their assets after retirement. The correct answer is C, their immovable and movable property at the intervals. Question number 49. Rule 12 deals with the prohibition of option A, lending and borrowing money, option B, accepting dowry, option C, engaging in private trade, option D, criticizing government policies. The correct answer is lending and borrowing money. Question number 50. Are central government employees allowed to wear uniforms during private social events? Option A, yes, if the event is official. Option B, yes, if the event is cultural. Option C, no, under no circumstances. Option D, yes, with departmental approval. The correct answer is C, no, under no circumstances. A government employee is allowed to wear uniform during private social events. These 50 questions of MCQ covers the most important aspect of Central Government Central Civil Service Conduct Rule 1964. If you have any doubt, please see the Conduct Rule 1964 for verification. I have discussed 50 important questions that are important for AC, principal, teacher, exam of KVS, NVS, Delhi or others. Please go through all the 50 questions which are most important. If you have any doubt, please verify from the CCS Conduct Rule 1964 available on DOPT website. If you like this video, please forward it to as many as teachers or persons preparing for these exams. If you like my video, please like it. And if you like my channel, please subscribe my channel. Thank you all.